What's up, y'all?
What's going on?
What's going on, man? We got Brother Zeke in the house.
That's right.
We got Yana.
Yes.
Sakara in the house.
Yes. What's going on?
And I'm Silky Black. Heck in the house.
Y'all like that? You like this too?
Amen.
Heck in the house.
Yeah.
What's up, Ronnie? My cousin Ronnie watching? Where you at, man?
Coming to the show.
Yeah, thank you for coming to the show, coming on the show, watching your little cousin. You know what I'm saying, man? What's up, Ayana? What's been going on, man?
Nothing.
Oh, what?
Okay. Nothing wrong with
it. Look at you. How you been responsible? Mm-hmm. How your baby doing?
She's good.
Oh, she's so sweet. Y'all, this is Aaliyah's mom.
Hello.
Aaliyah. Y'all, everybody loves Aaliyah. Everybody loves Aaliyah.
That's right.
But she couldn't make it with us today, so she's going to be mad at her mom. I want to be on the show. You was on the show.
She can just see mom.
Yeah, she gets to see. What's going on, Zach? How you been?
Hey, man, you know, I'm living, man. I'm blessed, man.
Yeah.
You know, you had two graduations last week.
What? In the family?
Yeah, the oldest and the youngest one.
What?
Yeah, 12th grade, and, you know, and the next week, well, it was last week, yeah, it was the kindergarten going to first grade.
So good.
Lots of cake cutting, lots of ice cream, you know. A lot of good stuff, yeah. Okay. Summer's here.
Man, it's a lot of stuff going on. It's a lot of people been graduating. I've been busy too. You know, DJing, parties, graduations, baby showers.
Baby showers.
I turned the baby shower out.
That's what I'm talking about.
You heard me?
That's what I'm saying.
Baby, I almost got here early.
So wait a minute. Oh, the baby wasn't even here.
Baby wasn't even here yet.
You was trying to bring the baby with the music.
Baby bouncing with mommy.
The baby was bouncing. Hey man, that's what I'm talking about. Man, support our brothers out here that's doing their thing. Black businesses, people that are doing stuff. Definitely support them. We need the love.
Yeah. Shout out to Naira. Having that baby boy in a couple more weeks. Man.
So
summer
awesome.
Baby. Mm-hmm. Yeah, we got a shout out to, what'd you say, black businesses?
All black businesses. I know sometimes people say it's a hassle. It may not be close. They may have had a bad experience. Yeah. But everybody ain't the same. Some people give excellent quality all the time.
Exactly.
So please support our black owned businesses. We definitely need it. We definitely need the love and the support, because without a child, we wouldn't be.
Yeah. Shout out to D-Rail.
D-Rail's up.
Super DJ on yeah. The DJ side.
Definitely. That's what's up.
But they got a lot happening out here in the streets.
Wait a minute. What's going on in the streets?
So much. Like we said last time, if we miss something, hey D. If we miss something, y'all please call in and let us know. Because I can't get all these stories. We be trying to get them. We got enough that can fit in an hour. We trying to do an hour. We trying to fit them in here. We got a lot of them. So feel free to call in and be like, what about such and such? Just like last week, right?
Man, last week was deep.
Last week got pretty deep.
Got deep quick, fast, and hurry.
Because last week he was actually talking about some floods was going on up north somewhere. Mm-hmm. And now, what's up with Tori? And now it's volcanoes in Guatemala. Yo, you seen it?
Yeah.
You know, Guatemala, that's close to, you know, Costa Rica.
Yeah.
The Coca-Cola. You know, it makes me wonder, all these, you know, you got Hawaii, they got theater thing going on. Now Guatemala, like, is this something like going on in the environment? Is we doing too much drilling?
What's going on?
Yeah, like,
seriously, what's question, Zach?
I don't know, but I'm just saying, we, you know, all these catastrophes. Remember, like, 1 year, it was, like, hurricane season, then it was tsunamis. Now it's the year of volcano eruptions.
Yeah.
So I hope the family is safe.
A lot of people say it's from the fracking. And I think, you know, I was working out there with frack. I don't know what they say they're looking for oil, but I don't know, man. It's a lot going on. I might not be able to say this live. They might come get me.
Hold on. You write it down.
Okay.
Yeah, you have to write it down. Yeah,
scratch that.
But no, you know, you got to make a point. You remember a few years ago, they had the BP thing and the oil spill. And, you know, out there on the oil rigs, I mean, them guys be pumping hundreds of thousands of gallons of oil.
Yeah.
And I'm just saying, after a while, that does something, you know, to the what happened simply black. It happened to what? He said, what happened simply black?
What's happening?
Oh, he's just saying what's happening. Like, oh, what's happening? Okay. No, but now, I don't know. All that drilling, all that, you know, us trying to necessarily get, you know, oil and stuff.
Right. How much oil do you need? How many bicycle chains out there? Yeah.
I'll tell you what, these gas prices, it's going to be some more.
It's funny because, I mean, we have our own supply in Texas, but they want to go out and go, you know, across the seas and, you know, make money.
Right.
It's all about the money. That's all it really is.
Oh, yeah. We also, too, we set the standard for the world. So, you know, we can't just, you know, share what. We probably got enough oil in the reserve to last us 100 years. But they still going to get more.
Of course.
And then when everybody run out, we're going to charge them everything for it. Because
they all about the money.
We all know the 1% is free.
We get deep right now. We just jump right into it.
The 1%.
Yeah, no, you're right. You're right.
Write that down.
That's 1%.
Can't say that one down.
Write that one down too. That's whoa.
Can get us,
man.
If these mics cut off, man. Run.
Hold on. You know, y'all don't sell cars. You come.
What's up, Ty?
Man, that's what's up. Man. I don't know if it's the drilling. But it's a lot of things going on. I mean, you hear about these, Arctic, you know, where, you know, the big ice, that's melting.
Yeah. What's up, Benjamin? Benjamin Goods, super artist in the house.
Yeah, what's happening? Well,
yeah, man, it's, the ice melting, it's getting hotter. Well, they say it's getting hot. But I remember it being this hot when I was little.
It's always hot.
I don't know about y'all, but it's been this hot.
Yeah, it's always
hot. And we stayed outside. I guess we was used to it, man.
Well, I mean, yeah, it's a different breed. It's a different breed. It's a different time.
Uh-oh, we got one on the show today. Well, a different breed. Is it hot?
Yes, that's a good question. Like, I mean,
I'm thinking, because, I mean, when I was little, we used to go outside all the time. And we used to always ride our bikes and everything. And of course, when you're little, stuff it doesn't affect you as much as when you're older. So
it's hot now.
It's hot.
Okay.
I'm sweating.
I think we all agree that it's hot. We're not saying that, but I think
it's about the same hot.
It's about the same hot. I think, and then you know, we used to have to stay outside.
We stayed. We didn't want to come in.
We didn't want to come in. If it was to get some. To go back out.
Exactly.
So I don't know.
And then you better not get caught in the tube when you have to stay. That was your sentence.
Well, I mean, most of the time, be somewhere not too far so you can hear mama's voice.
Yeah.
And then, you know, come in and then you just wait for the next day. Because you usually didn't get something finished. So whether you was outside, playing basketball, playing baseball, or just running around,
Just had to get out there.
Good old days. These kids now is a little bit different, so.
Yeah, because it ain't safe.
No, it ain't safe.
We got a story. We're going to start with the story, y'all. We're going to start with all the backwash.
Wait a minute, hold on, before we get the stories. Anything happened in Houston? That we wasn't like, you know, this past week. With the sports. With the
Ain't nothing.
We gotta talk about the last show.
Ain't nothing happened, man.
That'll mean about the
ain't nothing happened, man.
The Houston Rockets.
Oh, that's a basketball team.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
That was your team, though, right?
Mm-hmm.
That's your team?
No, I'm going for LeBron, man. LeBron, you know, I'm Cavaliers all the way, baby.
James.
Yeah. Oh, man. Yeah. Oh, yeah. That's the Cleveland Cavaliers. Now, okay.
Oh, yeah. I mean, I was just doing that to
inspire them to plug his family.
No, I was doing that. You know.
So the next episode, you may have a Cleveland Cavalier.
Yeah, I might have a hat on. I gotta go get support, man.
Come on now, that's what's up. That's what's up. Let's go ahead and jump to that first stuff.
You just had to throw it out there, huh?
Nah,
man, ain't nobody thinking about the Rockets. The Rockets gonna give somebody high blood pressure.
They had us, man. We were there. We were there.
Every year they do the same thing every year. It's like you should just watch the old basketball, the old playoff.
I mean, we credit to them. I mean, you know, James Harden did his thing. It's just hard to play for the best players at the same time. You just won. And Chris Paul got hurt.
On purpose. I ain't.
I ain't gonna say.
I'm gonna write that down too.
Whoa, wait a minute. No, definitely won't.
Don't wanna come.
Hey, what's going on, Benjamin? How? What's up? Hey, thank you for coming in. Okay, you said you had a story for us, man. What's going on?
Yeah, man. I was saying it ain't safe with the kids. It ain't safe no more. It ain't safe. No, but you remember the little girl that got supposedly locked in the freezer and died mysteriously in some hotel party thing?
A few months ago, yeah.
Yeah, okay. So, rest in peace, young lady. Her friend was found dead with her fingers chopped off in an abandoned house.
Whoa.
In the same area. So, what I'm thinking is, in this area they in, somebody know about organ farmers, and they making money off them little kids.
Yeah. That's
crazy. Why was her fingers popped off? Probably because she scratched one of them, and it was evidence in there. So.
I'm just thinking.
So, she probably scratched somebody, had some evidence on their fingernails, and. You know, they cut
her
fingers off, man. What's going on?
Man, that's cold.
Y'all got to be careful out here. And there's stuff like this going on, man. And what in the world? It is so much. Is we getting killed by the cops? Oh, her fingers and her organs is missing.
Her fingers and her organs? Yeah. Oh. Well, see, that's the thing about it. You know, in certain parts of the world, you know, I mean, a lung is big business. I think we imitate. Well, then it's got to be the black market they're doing it to, because I mean, my thing is it we in a certain part, or well, that's part of it, but also is it just nobody's gonna go looking after, you know, get the proper justice because it's a young black girl. Wow. I saw a thing on the, you were saying about police brutality. I seen it. It was a clip on the news, and it was like this full-grown officer had this young boy pinned down. You hear people in the background saying, "He's just a kid. You don't have to get him." It's just, man, hell no. I just said to myself, you know, I mean, it's not safe. Like you say, so.
There's all kind of ways.
Maybe that's the reason why the kids aren't, you know, going out and playing. I don't know, but. I mean, it's definitely parents out there keeping an eye on the kids, you know, communication, keep it open.
What's up, Mark? Another one of my cousins?
Fingers and arms are missing, man.
Fingers and organs are missing. Nobody. And this wasn't even big news. Why ain't this big news?
Well, let's talk about that Mississippi babies. That's still a big news. And, yes, it's modern day lynching in 2018. Nobody's seen it. Nobody's seen it? Oh, man. did y'all see the one, and I don't know if we covered this, if we did, let me know, because I mean, it was just so shocking. The guy who was the teacher that supposedly ran the hotel, got naked, ran the car, rolled in the car, ran into something, jumped out the car naked, rushed the officer, ran in the freeway, got hit, rocked in the freeway for about 20 seconds, got up, charged the police officer, then the police officer tased him a couple times.
That and didn't work.
He shot him a couple times. That did work.
Yeah, I saw that video.
Okay.
That was
disturbing, but what was even more disturbing is when you found out, okay, the guy was a high school biology teacher, and he was respected by a peer. So what happened? What you know, and I think the family and by the way, let me say that the cop that shot him wasn't white, he was a black cop. However, the family wanted some kind of toxicology on his blood to see, you know, was he mentally ill?
No, that wasn't mental. That was from drugs.
Mm-hmm.
Well, yeah. Well, that's something that we got. Well, I thought it was that.
The what?
The Krillac.
It's the Krillac? I thought it was the Flocker.
Oh, that too.
The Flocker. Right? Have you heard about the Flocker?
That's Waka Flocker.
Waka.
Well,
oh, yeah,
Waka Flocker Flocker. Well, I know the Flocker make him run through stuff. That dude was not, I mean, if you watch the video, it's going to be different opinion. People going to say the officer, you know, it was justified. Dude was naked, he charged him. You know, he tased him, he reached and grabbed and cut the officer. And he said,
I'm with the officer on this one.
Mm-hmm. I mean, when you watch it, I mean, it was what you call it.
I mean, it was sad, but still, with this one,
what do you do? Now, if it was maybe in the news and it was maybe not black, he might have got shot faster than that.
Oh, yeah, a long time ago.
Oh, absolutely.
I mean, let's just do it.
Because the guy said,
Yeah,
he said, if you don't put that taser down, I'm gonna kill you.
It was the way he said it, man.
Yeah, I said, wow. Yeah, I pulled out my gun.
And then when he you pulled out, just you watching it, he just pulled it out.
Pulled it out, like, hey,
yeah.
It's a threat to an officer.
Yeah, it's just a threat. Yeah, and there's a lot of good officers out there. Definitely officers out there that's doing their job. They don't get credit for them.
Officers.
Definitely. So
yeah, they don't get credit. They don't get credit for what they do. Like they do have a lot of, they got a lot of good cops out there. Mm-hmm. Like this guy was following everything. He was like, sir, you're ball. No, I hate to say that.
Well, you know.
But
he was the clothes on, man.
Yeah, he was trying to
stalk. I ain't signed up for all this.
Yeah. The dude was stark naked. First he crashed.
Bucket naked. Yeah.
Then he hit somebody first, right?
He hit somebody, veered off, hit a tree, jumped out feet first, butt naked, charged past the officer, got hit by an oncoming car.
Yeah.
Got up, charged the officer again, threatened him. Officer tased him twice. Took two shots, was still going. Like, yeah, he was on.
Yeah, he got hit.
He got hit
by a car, rolled around in the freeway. For about, what, 11, 10 seconds?
Yeah, he rocked out there. Yeah. On the hot concrete, this is what you know.
You know how Peter Griffin would go?
The dude was out there. he was bucket naked out there.
That's what he did for about 40 seconds.
About 40 seconds.
Then he got up and ran at the cop. And then he told him, if you don't put your taser down, I'm going to kill you. I was like, Yeah, scared. So I pulled my gun and tased him. Yeah. What's up, LaPortia? We got Louisiana in the house. Deep. Thank y'all.
I'm definitely.
And that scared me. That one scared me. Because a lot of them people on those type of drugs, they just be to themselves and they turn in circles and they really can't move. Mm-hmm. But this guy was coming after people.
Well, see, my thing about the video that was even more disturbing than that is after the guy had been shot, he was, you know, security. You hear the officer saying, hey man, you might have to shoot him or tase him and use some more lethal force if necessary. And then they only played that. And you hear a security officer tell them, you know, go and to basically sit down, calm down. And he was very, you know, agreeing to him, and he did that. But my fear is that they use this as a training video and say, see, this is what we have to use the other force because this is how it comes out.
Yeah, this is how they act.
This is how they act, right? But this isn't obvious. This was an isolated situation where I think the cop was in more in the right than the wrong. I mean, he tried, he took steps. I saw that.
He saw the guy get hit by a cop.
I think it was, he took it out. He just thought it was in the little further than that. This dude.
What's up, Cotton?
Man, this guy here, he did his,
scary. Scary stuff. But we don't want to scare y'all to death. Hey, but we want to talk a little bit about sports. We talked about the NBA.
Who voted to the NFL, man?
Nothing.
So
that's ridiculous.
I did. I boycotted. I put it on my page.
What's up,
Tony? That I am boycotting the whole 2019-2018 season.
Yeah.
They got to start supporting some of these players. That's there. That's for this injustice. Yeah. And unfortunately, you know, the players, you know, I understand them. They got jobs. They're trying to take care of their families. But the fans pay the salaries.
Right.
And if enough fans say, hey, we're not going to stand up and support you guys unless you do it, I think you'll see more, you know, so.
More change. And, of course, I got a couple cousins in the NFL.
Right.
I do not want them to be, for their income to be taken away.
No.
But
no.
I don't want them end up choked out or dead either.
Well, see, my thing is that if the fans support it and we support the players and don't go to the games, that'll cause change because it'll affect their money.
Yeah.
So, I mean, I'm saying we've had, you know, Kaepernick, a couple other players get blackballed for standing up. And you see they're not strong enough to fight against it. But if the fans do it, then
it's something. I feel like if they all just boycott, if they all do it, then they can't really reprimand every single player.
Right.
Hey, Kia. Hey, Lisa. Right.
I mean, it would be a united front. Y'all can't really do much about that unless you want
to
change
it. Right. They gonna have to all do it at one time.
Yes.
It's gonna have to be a whole, all of them.
But wait.
In one stadium.
Wait. Right. But I'm saying if this. When have black people always get along together? You know, like, is that possible?
Yeah,
Jim Crow laws.
I'm just saying. Like,
when the pyramids were built, we kind of got together.
Well, let's just say, like.
What?
Did we get together or were we forced together?
We were enslaved.
When the pyramids were built?
By our own people,
yeah. But it was still black people. It wasn't enslaved. Learn a little bit of something else. About that. No, I'm telling you, that's not the truth. That's what they want you to believe. It was strategy and knowledge that put them pyramids together. It was not slaves.
Thank you. You know those, it was like the was it Giza, whatever, where the one everybody go to. Each one of those pillars of stone, say they weigh 100 or 1,000 tons or something. Who could pick it up? They had to have some ingenuity.
Yes, they had to. And it wasn't slaves. It wasn't slaves. And if you don't believe me, a white man said it.
Okay. Oh, man. What's going on in entertainment? What you got,
niece? What you got, niece?
Well,
I'm sorry. Yana Sakara.
Yana Sakara, yes.
Drake and Pusha T.
Ah!
So, did Pusha go too far and pull a Remy Ma? Or, like, you know how she did with Nicki? Or is this just, you know, rap beef? You know,
I mean, okay.
Look off the couch.
Okay, so let's talk rap beef. Because, you know, in the 90s, rap beef ended up with Pac and Biggie getting killed. Then rap kind of died down. Beefs kind of stopped. 50 yeah. Cent did it for a while. And beef hey, wasn't hot. And now beef is coming back. And so, like, okay, so let me not understand. Was it, who went after who first?
Well, it was Pusha after Drake.
So he baited him?
Yes, and then Drake
fell for the bait. Okay.
Went after Pusha, and then Pusha came back and basically murdered him.
Okay, well, if y'all don't know who Pusha T is, Pusha T was with a group called The Clips back in the day.
Yeah, that's right.
When the last time you heard it like this? Like this. That's the beat. I don't really know the whole song. It was a real good song. I like the song. And they had Crying Bean. So that's Pusha T.
Well,
I think
Pusha T handled Drake.
Pusha T. Well, okay, let's go into what was brought up. I mean, he said that his mom basically never had a husband.
He said a lot of things.
Well, I'm just touching the highlights.
Okay, yeah. His mom didn't have a husband.
Okay.
Never had a husband.
Right.
He said that Drake has an illegitimate child, and he also...
Wait a minute, but illegitimate stripper.
With the porn star.
The porn star, right.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And he also said his best friend is dying in front of his face.
And something about, like, his... He had issues
with... So who are you talking about? Pushing Drake or Donald Trump?
I thought it was going to be a Trump freezing. Yeah.
Okay, well, when the carrot's in office.
Yeah.
Oh. Dun-dun-dun-dun. Man.
So, okay, he goes after him and all this shit. And everybody, hey, did y'all see it was a picture of Drake? He was like a black face.
Yes.
And I think that was given the biggest thing. And then when the stuff hit, people were waiting for him to respond. Like, come on. And then he took the thing to respond. And his comments were saying that that picture was taken when he was an actor. He was doing something in like 07. And I think is he was, and I got to give comedian Trevor Noah, he brought come to this. Man, who are these detectives put? I mean, he found out everything about Drake. Like,
it was already
he's the Perry Mason of, like, the...
It was already out there, though.
Yeah, it really was.
It's been out there for the longest. I don't,
well, I guess nobody...
A lot of people didn't really...
Man, I mean, he just but hit him with some some facts.
I did see that they compared that picture to
Zeno?
To a picture of Beyonce.
Okay.
And she basically did blackface kind of too.
Okay. A lot of people did blackface.
Exactly.
Sure. You remember Tommy Davidson and
Spike Lee movie.
Damon Wayne.
Yeah, that was Bamboozle. Was it Bamboozle? Yeah. Yeah, it happens.
Robert Downey Jr.
Robert Downey Jr. Yeah.
But they did touch on
Tropic
how that he was really black, and they touched on how that was racist.
Yeah, but I mean, anybody seen Tropic Thunder?
Hey, Misha.
It's supposed to be a funny
movie. It's a funny movie. It could have been offensive. I think he's a really good actor. I'm just saying. Yeah. I mean, he Robert Downey Jr.
Oh, Iron Man?
Yeah, Iron Man. He played Tropic Thunder. He played the brother.
Yeah.
Yeah, what you talking about? I think it was, maybe it was a stretch.
She's like, you're white.
You're white, yeah.
It was a stretch.
But one can say, you know, when Dave Chappelle played racist white guy, but he played him black on the Chappelle Show. I mean, come on.
Yeah. Well, speaking of rap beefs, I wouldn't really call this a rap beef, but there's this new rapper. I think you guys heard of him, Tekashi 6ix9ine.
Okay.
And then,
yeah, he's is that the one? No. Is that the one that's beefing with
Chief Keef?
Well, I know about Chief Keef, but I don't know about the Chief Keef. I thought he was beefing with J. Cole.
Oh, no. That's
Lil Pump. Okay, Lil Pump.
Yeah. So basically, Chief Keef is following Tekashi across the globe, and is trying to kill him.
Wow.
Because 6ix9ine basically posted on social media, F Chief Keef and Lil Breeze, and Chief Keef is known for killing people.
For those who don't know
people.
Chief Keef was part of the Bloods in Chicago. Started that drill music down there, got real popular. They were like 14, 15 doing videos in the house. Guy blew up, moved to LA. I mean, I haven't really been following his music too much the last couple of years, but I know he's been putting out albums. This guy that you mentioned, is that the one that's got the 69 on his face or something?
Yes.
Yeah, that, like a white guy or something? Okay, okay.
Well, he's Hispanic.
He's a Hispanic. Okay, I thought
either way.
You know them Hispanics.
Man.
Don't play, first of all. Second of all, I don't like him at all.
Uh-oh. Horrible. Is he, what are they... I don't understand what's up. So that's the thing now. If you're not rapping, you're not communicating, you're mumble rapping, you're not doing it, you're not drill music, then you beefing. That's the thing now.
And it's too much of the other news going on for him to be doing this mess. This is what I'm talking. It's people, little girls getting their organs taken and their fingers chopped off for nothing.
Oh, I'm looking at the video. Looks like.
What is it?
Washing them down or something?
It's too much to fix.
Either way, he's an abomination.
What guy is that?
That's him. That's 6ix9ine.
That's 6ix9ine right there. 6ix9ine. With the rainbow colored hair right there.
He had Kool-Aid in his hair.
Yeah, cool it all in.
Basically, it's a whole rainbow.
Yeah, he had Kool-Aid in his hair. Fluorescent. Green, pinkish stuff. I don't even know where you get that color from.
Yeah.
Hobby Lobby?
I don't know.
It do me.
It keeps the color. But you know, going back to Drake and this Pusha T beat, a lot of people are talking about the one that intervened and stepped in and told Drake to just leave it alone.
Jay Prince.
OG he used to
do.
Nobody's saying nothing about James. That's not what we say. We saying that James celibate.
Hey, Kanye, hey,
some people are beefing about that, saying that said Reno's being overshadowed. What's being
overshadowed by fake news?
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah.
Very true.
Yes.
They call it nowadays for clout. That's the new word.
That's the Snapchat words. You all know.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And the beef is over. Yeah, Lil James said it's over. It's over.
Uh-oh. And I know he said it's slow.
Yeah.
It's over.
Well, I think the comment that don't come said... Here. I think the comment, and I'm paraphrasing, so... Please give him that one. It was like he was something like James called Prince James called Pusha T something like a cow or something that got too fat. That basically, pretty much that basically, you know, disrespected, you know, Drake and you know, I think that, you know, we don't really need that.
Yeah.
We don't need people beefing. We don't need none of that right now. And Drake making money. Like, so, I mean, really.
Drake did a whole video of him giving money to the people where
he in Miami, yeah. What was the name of that song?
God's Plan.
God's Plan, yeah. That's dope right there.
Almost made me cry. I wasn't so tough,
man,
I probably would have cried.
Well, you know, some of those people, they put that money in and they cried for real.
Oh, yeah, they cried for real.
I mean, he was putting some stacks, especially the one with the mother and the son.
That wasn't professional cameras. That was handheld footage.
Mm-hmm. No, what he did was, that, he, like they said in the beginning, whatever that $1 million budget, gave it all away.
What a thing. Push your T where you at? It looks like Drake still winning.
Uh-oh. Well, let him give $1 million. Let him give him. Remy Ma did all that barking
for nothing.
Why don't y'all make a song together?
What
happened to self-destruction? You had it for, you remember that? Yeah, all the rappers was on that one song.
You ain't got that no more. Mm-hmm. I don't see that no more.
Can somebody do a remix of self-destruction? Matter of fact, just put it out again because it's still relevant.
Yeah, we need to play some of the old school. Because it's still relevant to the new school.
It's still relevant, man. Mm-hmm. They don't listen to it. Y'all call in if y'all got something for us. 713-714-7670. That's a perfect song. Exactly, kind of.
I know we were talking about Trump. drunk before, but I'm gonna have to bring the kid back up again because he was just in the office with him.
Oh, you mean what office? The Oval Office.
Yeah, talking about prison reform.
Close the door.
They had the door cut shut.
Well, the thing about it is the whole prison reform, was that the thing that Kanye's mother was trying to advocate for or something? What was she trying to advocate for?
I know she was trying to get some girl that's been circulating on the internet off of death row?
Yes.
Death row because I don't know.
So,
I didn't really pay attention to it. I heard the story though.
What Kim is trying to do is take over Donna's house.
Uh-oh.
And
who, Donald or Donna?
Donna.
Like Donald Trump? I'm just playing. Go ahead, girl.
So it's crazy that it's just this reality TV star who got her fame by posting a sex tape is going to this carrot to talk about prison reform.
That's right.
And is trying to take over something that was rightfully for a black woman who knew what she was doing. So to me, it's just
somebody
like
somebody take credit.
Like you want to take credit, basically. You know, just like every other colonizer. Every other thing that she's done.
Word of
since she's been culture appropriating from the beginning, and this is just another thing of culture appropriation to me.
Well, you know what's interesting is like when Meek Mill got out and everybody was Meek Mill, prison reform. It lasted real good for about a week.
Oh yeah.
A couple of nights. Well, you know when the 76ers were in the playoffs.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And then after they got booted, then it was like. So I don't know.
Where's Meek now?
Meek said he was going to dedicate
his career
toward advocating because he said he realized that everybody wasn't as fortunate. You know, everybody will be picked up in a helicopter,
right,
and flown to a playoff game.
And shower at the stadium.
That's true.
To get a towel given by Kevin Hart.
Yeah, you know, and okay, he's not an athlete, right? You know he caught athletes stood up in them showers. If he can put no towel down, he caught athlete's foot.
What
size
he
was 13s up
he was so happy to get out there. He sprinted to the thing.
Who draws are you?
Man.
So I guess they had everything just ready for him.
Sounds just like that's how it is.
Everybody ain't able.
That's why I'm saying, like, they need to have people that's got money, that are these rappers that can advocate, that can give information, that can get people off that, that know the facts to support it. And they can come together.
Yeah.
You know, put their money where their mouth is. I like what now one of the biggest advocates about prison reform, Master P. You know, because he got a brother serving the life sentence. He's always trying to get it. You know, he's doing stuff like, you know, I think he was out of, I want to say Miami, or I know it was in LA. He was giving out free glasses, you know, to the community, just saying that, hey man, the kids get to see.
You're right.
And glasses, y'all know, are expensive. So
all the parents out there know them glasses are expensive.
Yeah.
Contacts, glasses, all of that.
That's right.
Cost you a head, cost an arm and a leg.
And the toe. The big toe.
The big toe, yeah. So.
Yeah, well. That's the end of the beef. But y'all, man, don't beef, man. Make a song together. Make rap great again.
Man, I'm on. Make rap great again.
Man, it's Silky for president.
Silky, man, that was a good motto.
Let me write that down.
Rap great again. Okay, so you talked about Kardashian. I gotta talk about her because he hit the news today. Kanye said that he was diagnosed with mental illness at 39. He's not 40. And I'm like, Negro, somebody, you've been crazy a long time. You didn't just get diagnosed at 39. I'm just saying. It's what he's saying is so crazy. But
it's to the point that some people actually believe what he's saying. You know, he said that.
And the shirt makers, I need this shirt.
Hey, we need it. We need it. That was. I also made a comment today that light skin babies are more beautiful. Then I think he said dark skin babies or any other.
Whoa! Mix.
It was. You saying mixed babies? I think that was. D, check that for me. I know you was.
If he,
ready.
If he said that. If he did, that's such a lie.
Yeah. You said interracial babies were more beautiful than the black babies.
In so
the
he hated himself. End of discussion. He hates himself.
Man, I just wonder, man, if mama could come back just for
mama don't want to come back.
A split second just to just look at her. Like, you know.
Dre said he need a make rap great again shirt in 3X. I got you. I got you. What's up, Jaquel? What's up, Rich? Yeah. Make rap great again t-shirt. That'll be nice. I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna go ahead and do that. Call my people. Mm-hmm.
So yeah, I mean that's
so I had. Well, she's a grown woman now, but this little girl was such a beautiful girl when she was a baby. People thought she was a baby doll. Her name is Takiwa Roberts. Mm. She was such a beautiful little baby. Dark skin, too. Mm. Big old eyes, big cheeks. Oh, she was such a beautiful baby. She's still a pretty lady. Mm. But the baby, oh, she was such a cutie. I went down the so Kiwa, if you watch it, hey cutie pie, that's my little cousin, y'all. Mm-hmm. I'm sorry.
You back?
I'm back.
Okay.
Man, she almost threw me in the baby fever.
I thought we almost had. I mean, other than the, you know, the volcanic eruptions, man. I had. See the thing that went across that said, "Ooh, there comes the last one." I'm like, "Oh,
you know, oh yeah!"
And I was like, "You know, I went and I wasn't seeing it on CNN news. Like, did you hear that story?"
Now I had to find it on Black America Web. His son died.
Ah, okay.
His son died at the age of 60. Junior, I didn't even know he had a junior.
I know that. I know you got a lot of kids. I don't want all of them.
Yeah.
I know you got a lot of kids. Yeah, but my thing is, I guess when I had heard and I thought it was him that passed, I was like, man, he connected to Malcolm. I mean, like, you know, and I definitely write this down. We're not saying nothing about the nation. We want Farrakhan to be here forever because he's really one of the leaders that are out here doing the things and saying, speaking. About plight. I think most of his career, almost all his life, he dedicated to the plight of uplifting black people. And so I was just thinking, though, after he's gone, who else is there that is a real leader that's not scared?
A real leader
that will speak their mind. You know, it's like, cause, man, you put enough money, like, I mean, it's just like, I was watching an old. It was an old interview with Charlie Murphy, and he was talking about, you know, he offered Dave Chappelle that money, and Dave Chappelle said, nope, walked away from it. And Charlie Murphy said, I could have done it. Walked away from all the millions. I mean, he was joking about it, but you know.
Yeah. A lot of people couldn't, man. Right? That's a, because I guess, like Dave Chappelle, he believed in himself. He know he can get money.
Well, he got his money back.
Yeah. And like
you created said, a special sold to Netflix for $60 million, basically giving the blueprint to everybody out there.
Because the people don't think that they can do it.
Don't try to get the deal. Go here, create your stuff, and sell it to them. That's what you do. Get your money.
Absolutely. Get your money.
Get your money quickly.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. They had another. They had another barbecue Becky. But this was Pool Patty. So, long story short, they had some black people in the pool. Had a white lady come along, and she wanted to talk to everybody. So they was actually doing a video shoot, and so they was like, we're doing something right now. She got mad because they didn't want to talk to her and called the cops. She called the cops on them because they didn't want to talk to her. So the cop came, he was listening to her story, and she obviously sounded drunk or something. And so he was like,
She probably wasn't. She probably was in her right mind.
Exactly. Yeah. Exactly.
She probably wasn't drunk. Yeah.
She probably was herself.
Yeah.
And so he talking to her, he was like, so where did the threat come in? And she never could answer. He kept asking her, where did the threat come in? How were you threatened? Oh, well, they said, well, one girl, she says she's kind of keeping me out. He was like, are you sure you didn't say that first?
Right.
Well, I did say that, but she said she was going to beat me up.
Wow.
He was like, yeah, thank you.
And I'm depressed, and I was just trying to talk to her and tell her that I was depressed.
Yeah.
Wait a minute. What difference? Oh, I'm sorry. Go ahead. Go ahead and say. I'm just thinking. What's different than that story than the woman that's supposed to lie on the police officers and say that, you know?
Yeah. Exactly.
They blew that up.
Exactly.
They don't blow this one up.
Exactly.
Two Americas.
Two Americas. That's a good point, Zach.
You got two Americas, man. Everybody knows that. Well, not everybody. Black people know that.
Black people know that.
It's two Americas.
What's going on with you? Oh, but these people are going through it too, and they have this going on too. That's basically your
they get it too.
All lives matter, the black lives matter. But let me not get deep into this.
when you got the leader of the free world that jumps on and says, you know, he canceled the. And I don't want to jump back to sports, but you know, when you win the Super Bowl, you could go to the White House.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
But because so many of the Philadelphia Eagles were outspoken about Trump, he canceled their trip.
Mm-hmm.
I think this was like the first time that's ever happened. Like, he said, well, if you don't support me, you don't come to the White House.
Oh.
So, yeah, he got his feelings about it.
What a doozer.
But yet they said that a woman in office would have had, you know, been more in her feelings about every situation that happened. But you're acting with your emotions.
No.
Nothing but your emotions, dude. Like, what are you doing?
All about emotions.
That's H-Town, y'all. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
H-Town.
That's right.
All the people.
Mm. Janet Jackson, y'all heard about this?
Oh yeah.
I heard about Janet Jackson.
Wait a minute. Sister Michael.
Janet Jackson. Little sister.
All right. Penny. Penny from Good Time.
Had to call the cops on her estranged baby daddy.
Wait. Jermaine Dupri? We ain't talking about that. We ain't talking about it. It ain't the billionaire she's with. Jermaine Dupri, I thought he was back in the building. They were seen together, spotted, no? Okay.
Nope. This was the
billionaire. Okay.
Who told Janet Jackson by the nanny that this guy was acting aggressive. Now, I don't know if it was toward the baby, or toward her, or who, or what, but the guy was acting aggressive. So, Janet gets the word, hey, baby daddy, I can't have a person. So she's like, control.
So she picked up the phone. She got control.
She picked up the phone.
That black sister came out and was like, you ain't finna hit my baby.
You ain't finna do nothing.
You not finna do nothing.
So she called the cops and told the cops to go check that bitch. Check on my baby. She probably said like,
but how did the cops come up to a billionaire? You know they know you're a billionaire.
You know they work for him.
She don't know that.
What? What?
Don't
There you go.
Anyway, the cops went over there and checked on that, and they said the baby was perfectly fine. I guess she was just trying to check and see, because she can't call Michael.
Wow.
I don't know where that come from.
Hey, you know,
it's the month of his death,
hey,
too.
Hey, I have to say this, because Eddie Griffin brought it up when he did the Def Jam thing. And you know, everybody know he's famous for, you know, the Michael Jackson, you know, I think he did a Michael Jackson on crack back when Def Comedy Jam. Uh-huh. And he got up and he did this little thing. He was like, the only person at night, and crossed his arms. And he's like, too late.
Oh,
yeah. You know what I'm saying? It's, don't talk about Mike. Mike is gone. Leave Mike alone, man. Let Mike rest.
Mike rest.
But where's Jermaine at? Jermaine Dupri, he not in, hey, he got an opportunity now.
Jermaine is running a rap game. That's what he's doing.
He's running a
rap. This ain't a game. This the rap game.
Man.
You know what? All them little kids.
I don't know.
It's a TV show on,
Wait a minute, what is it? The little kids that you interviewing, like rappers and stuff?
Yeah, so he has a show where.
Arts and something. I've seen it before.
So you talk about this Jermaine with the hairline.
Yeah.
With the plastic rap.
Uh-huh.
Black plastic.
You have
trash bag hairline. Man.
Oh, wow, okay. Well, yeah, so I mean, he does have this TV show called The Rap Game, and he's had it for several seasons now, I guess. But he's basically trying, you know how he did Bow Wow and Romeo and all that, and you know, back in the day, he's basically trying to find another Bow Wow to bring up into the spotlight. But it's like a reality TV show where they have to fight for the top and stuff, and
like
basically
before.
Like, yeah, like that. Like, who's the best rapper?
Mm.
And yeah.
Good.
Something like that.
Janet Jackson's grabbing her baby.
Okay.
Jermaine Dupri running the rap.
So why he got the baby anyway? I thought she got custody.
Well, when you're $1 billion, you got $1 billion.
You can buy.
You can have what you want.
You can buy them court orders.
Buy a court. And a jail.
Ooh. He probably bought.
What you want? That yacht?
Got it.
I need my baby tonight. I need it tonight.
There's your check now, sir.
Yeah. Oh yeah. Oh no, it was already wired.
Want your baby tonight?
Yeah.
I go get him right now.
Yeah. Why is it on the
Janet, way? I don't know if you did a come up or mess up.
Well, I mean, you know, I mean, Mike still got his estate. They got the Jacksons.
Mike
got money.
Mike ain't
got that money. Well, I don't know. When Mike died, you know, his portfolio quadrupled. You know, he went.
His mama.
He was in debt. Well, I think mama got it. Yeah.
But
she'll
be
in Barcelona
for
mama.
They didn't go on a reunion tour for nothing, though.
They don't have any money.
And they had that TV show. Well, had. I don't know if it's going to
be. Did Jenny go on at any time?
No. She had money.
Did LaToya go on it? Was LaToya on it?
Nah, she did.
Was LaToya on it? On the show?
I don't think so. I never watched it.
LaToya still got money. It's Tito, Marlon, and Jermaine.
Reba, though.
They don't even mention Reba. Reba's like, you know, I'm Jackson.
Reba's a babysitter.
I'm a Jackson. I'm a real Jackson.
Well, she already
got like
the babysitter now. Well, no.
Blanket big. Blanket is a comforter. Blanket is a quilt now.
Blanket is my age, I think.
Blanket is a comforter now.
A comforter?
It's a whole.
California
kid, man? Yeah. He's a whole picnic.
Okay. Roseanne!
Yes. Y'all can call in and talk to us if y'all want to. Call in the number 713-714-7670. 713-714-7670, huh? 713-714-7670.
What's up with Roseanne? What is she doing about it? She lost the show. It's over.
Mm-hmm.
She still apologizing.
Oh, absolutely. Still going off on Twitter.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. I wouldn't even be speaking on Twitter. How much money did she lose?
She raced Twitter. Oh, God. Then a couple days when they said, you're fine. Mm-hmm. But, what's up, Royce? A couple days after she got fired, she turned.
No, it wasn't a couple days. It was that same day at 11 o'clock.
Oh, she turned.
The sister fired on the spot.
No, I'm talking about a couple days after she got fired.
Oh, okay.
She turned her Twitter off. Then, when they was talking about never bringing her back, then she started apologizing. Then she brought her Twitter back and what happened?
She was crying and whining and going, I never meant to call you that. But you know, she ain't lose that TV show because she called that woman a monkey, right? She lost the TV show because she called a white man a Nazi.
Mm.
Exactly. They don't care about us.
Mm. All I want to say is that they don't really care about us.
Well, I know the woman that canceled the show was African American, ABC.
And she was an eight. I'm only saying that because that's what Roseanne said. So you call somebody an eight and you got fired by an eight.
Ooh. Ooh, how that feel?
We need to have a segment on the show. I'm gonna write this down. Go sit your ass down somewhere.
Second.
Oh, yeah. So Roseanne Barr, this week on the show, you the first one. Congratulations. You got the first go sit your ass down somewhere award.
With all this glory.
Thank you. Yes.
Congratulations. You earned all
that.
Royce said eight more in.
Oh man.
First one, we're gonna have to make that a whole
first. I mean, yeah. she had to fire her whole staff. Nobody stepped in and said no before you press in.
Right.
She was probably in the comfort
of her home. Yeah, she probably was on the toilet.
She was
never
upset. She was full of shit. Yeah.
Well,
she ain't no more.
Oh.
She good, huh?
Oh, yeah. They did find her afterwards, walking around. She was on the phone with somebody, basically begging her producers to get her show back and everything. So somebody videotaped her. They were basically, she was just like, you know, I believe all people are good, and I love all people, and that's all I'm gonna say.
Why do people say something racist in the first and the second because they're not racist?
Well, honey, you're racist. Own up to your racism. You already did it on Twitter. Just do it now.
No, she do that all the time. This is the first time she ever got really in trouble behind. I guess you could say in trouble.
What's her name? The comedian.
On the Sykes?
No. The one that has the yellow hair.
Linnell.
Right. Yeah. Linnell, she was on Tom Jones show last week, and she was saying how she was a friend. Well, the way she put it is that
she was about to get a big role on the show.
Well, that too, but she said she considered her somebody that she socialized with, and they said, "Are you and y'all friends?" She would say yes, and she said she's actually heard her, you know, have said some things in public. She said, "But we don't as community, we don't talk politics." So you think what you think or whatever, but yeah, when she said that, not only she cost it, I think she cost it about 300 people their jobs.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, a lot of people. And they was talking about killing her off and calling it something else. Ooh. But y'all creative, make another show.
Sure. Use a spinoff.
Yeah.
Or just create a spinoff and call it for the nail show. And she have her own people come on.
Didn't she just get on it? She wasn't on it yet. Yeah.
Well, you can't make a Linnell show.
Well, she wasn't on there. She wasn't on there. But
Linnell funny.
She is funny. Real funny. I'm just saying.
What if she wanted to be a Queens of Comedy?
She always gonna be a Queen of Comedy.
Okay.
Oh, yeah. And she could get dirty. So,
oh yeah, she
could just get dirty. So
no, she would.
Put up, give her a shot. It's an opening.
Yeah.
They need a feeling. They need a, let me see. What we had, like?
Maybe they might be making room for the Super Black Show.
Oh. Thank you, Rose.
Oh, yeah.
For sitting your ass down.
Yeah.
Thank you.
We appreciate it.
Yeah. Making that slot open. You know,
open and available. Mm-hmm. ABC.
ABC, if you're listening, help! I want to see the Incredibles when that come out.
Yes, Incredibles 2
is coming out.
Wait.
Jurassic Park.
Deadpool 2.
No. Equalizer 2.
Ooh, when that
that's
come out?
I think it's coming out in July.
Wait,
yes.
What? I haven't heard anything.
Yes. You didn't see the trailer? We watched straight up, and it said it is off.
Equalizer 2.
Yeah, it's going to be better than the first. What is that? Oh, yeah, he don't want to.
Yeah, he
had one though. But he doing his thing, and that's one. This is going to be the blockbuster of the song.
Now, I know this ain't
have
nothing to do with Denzel, but I forgot I
wanted
to touch on this. Morgan Freeman.
Uh-oh. Back in the news.
You
want to
touch on Morgan Freeman?
Hold it back in. Okay.
No!
Let's bring it back.
Wait.
No, because he's been accused.
You want to touch on Morgan? You said you want to touch on this.
She want to touch on the subject.
Oh, okay.
That's what she said.
Oh, okay.
What about Morgan Freeman?
I personally do not believe that the allegations are true.
Mm-hmm. I believe it's true.
And no, because even one woman even came out and she was just, they were saying that it was some faulty information.
Okay.
It wasn't adding up.
You don't mean that to be safe.
Basically, it was just like, yo, like this is the next legend of a black man that y'all gonna tarnish in the media right now.
Okay.
Really? Are you serious? Morgan Freeman, not my Capricorn. Well, like, you can't do that.
Morgan Freeman didn't do it. The boss of God is safe.
I don't think Bill Cosby did it, but hey, I mean.
Bill did it. I think Bill admitted that he did it.
Bill said, I took the pudding pop.
I took the pudding, the chocolate, and the tapioca.
Okay, so I believe Bill Cosby was guilty but innocent. So yeah, he did some stuff that was very inappropriate.
Right.
But I don't think he did that to all of those women. All of those women that came out?
No.
I think it was just few of them and then everybody.
In this era, all you need is one.
Akilah St. Bill was at the party throwing pills like Steph Curry.
It was up in there.
Wow. Got you. Woo. Wow. Got you. Free throw. Got you too. Party all night.
And this, with these allegations with Mark Freeman, were they recent or something old like Bill?
Now, they saying that he was talking to some girl and basically the girl felt uncomfortable around him about what he was saying. So it wasn't like a touching type thing. It wasn't like a roofie type thing. It was just she felt uncomfortable about what he was saying.
Well, now that you said that, I did mention something about Steve Harvey, and it kind of flew under the radar.
Oh, I did see that.
Steve Harvey was supposedly, he had a guest on the show. This was some kind of mother.
I saw that.
And she came out saying he made her feel uncomfortable. And on the show, Steve was trying to build her up. I think she had a makeover or something. But
Steve Harvey.
Looked like he might do it. I'm just saying.
It was mostly the producers.
It was
the
producer. Okay.
They were saying that they told her they was gonna come on the show and do something else. But then they trolled her into doing something different.
Okay.
So they told her to put on these little clothes, these skimpy clothes, and then we're gonna bring you out here and like do a kind of makeover, I guess.
They told the audience
like what to say and
boo
her when she come out.
Wow.
So they can make
a lot of
crazy stuff, man. I'm
awful.
Just do your show, you don't have to make up nothing like that. People wanna come on the show anyway.
Well, I didn't see that on the show. I saw a clip. She came on there and Well, I saw the clip that I saw. She had came on there and she was already moving up. So that might have happened after.
Yeah, no, it happened first.
Okay.
Whenever they told her to put on the little clothes and she came out there and everybody was like,
yeah, because she was dressing inappropriately. I think that's what the thing for her, for her age. And he
too
had
sexy.
To, okay.
Too sexy for a mom.
Sorry.
Got you.
For a mom?
That's what they said.
I agree.
I'm not sexy, should a mom be?
So,
I mean, that's why I think a woman should wear whatever she wants to wear. Mm. But it shouldn't be up to anybody else to tell her how she looks and feels and whatever she wants to wear.
Even if she's even if she's a teacher or something.
There's a time and a place for everything.
Right.
Everyone knows that there is a professional setting that you have to
adhere to.
Okay. Of course you want to be a certain way in a professional setting. Now, outside of that professional setting, that's when you can wear whatever you want. You can do whatever you want. Mm. I mean, that just depends on your status, at least to me.
Okay.
What if what you wear makes you uncomfortable?
Well, then that's a you problem. You need to figure out what you're wearing. Why is what you're wearing making yourself uncomfortable?
Because we kind of talked about this a while ago. Like, you see girls with short skirts on, like,
that's peer pressure.
Mm-hmm. Peer pressure?
Absolutely.
Who told them to put this on?
Their friends.
I'm not talking about the ones that got dressed in front of their friends. I'm talking about the ones that got dressed by themselves.
And trust me, girls don't even get dressed by themselves. And I'm just being honest. They don't. They don't. Girls, if a girl is in a club or something like that and she's uncomfortable in what she's wearing, they got dressed with their friends. And they friends like, girl, you need to put this on, you need to put this on.
Oh,
you need
somebody
needs
a number.
Like this. So you
number,
can
please.
Get this dude or do this.
713-714-7670.
Please call in the comments.
Call in the comments. Thank you for calling. Yeah. But a lot of times, you know, I get dressed kind of things. You can't say that's peer pressure. I thought, what if they don't have no friends?
Well,
what if they're trying to go get a man?
Peer pressure.
Because
peer pressure.
That's still peer pressure, but it's just not. It's just not direct peer pressure. It's pressure from the social media.
Say that again.
It's pressure from social media.
And what else?
Just basically everything that they see. Oh, and guys, everything that they see on social media is, on Instagram, they want to be the Instagram model. They want to look perfect. They want to look like the next girl. And the next girl don't even look like the next girl.
That's right.
She don't even look like herself on them pictures. So what's the point of even looking like her? Look like you.
We finna get some conversation on.
We got
this.
A call coming in.
All right.
Okay. A call coming in.
Call from Atori.
Welcome.
Hey, young lady, you live on Talk Up. What's up? Talk
Yes.
Up.
Hello.
Hey.
Yeah.
How you doing?
I'm well. How are y'all doing?
What are we doing?
Y'all
look
so good.
Thank you for calling in. Could an argument be if the woman feel comfortable with her body and it's something tight that she wanna wear, that she feels okay? Is that okay?
Yes, definitely.
Okay.
And, yeah, wear it. But as far as or wearing something, you know, that she's uncomfortable in while wearing it.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, after a certain age, I don't believe there's any peer pressure. Like I said, a person is doing what they want to do. And a lot of times they're doing it for attention, whether it's for a man. A lot of times women, we do it, you know, for attention from other women. Mm-hmm. You know, to get, you know, oh, you look cute, or what did you get that, or this, what have you.
Okay.
So it's, you know, it's different variations as to why, you know, women do people. Well, let's say people do certain things, because men do it too.
Well, I mean, it's interesting that you say that, because, I mean, when you're talking about the women not having peer pressure, you know, at that point, I'm assuming you're talking about a person that's stable, secure with themselves, they know who they are, and et cetera. But would that be a case where you have an individual that doesn't have that self-esteem that, you know, might kind of be into peer pressure? Or what do you think about that?
There's a possibility, even with that in my opinion, you know, how long are you going to go with not having self-confidence or not, you know, loving yourself? You know, at a certain point, you have to inspire your own yourself.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying?
Uh-oh.
You can't look, read.
Could you say it again so everybody can hear it?
Oh, yeah, anybody else. I'm sorry, I didn't hear
No, I was saying, could you repeat it? See, it came upon people need to do what? I just wanted you to say it again. You said inspire.
Yes, you have to get inspiration from yourself. You can't wait and look for it from anybody else. Because if that's the case, you'll be looking all your life.
That's right.
And I say, church, preach.
Hey, we knew we was gonna get deep at some point. We knew it.
Yeah. Oh yeah, you got deep. Where you calling from?
I am calling from Tulsa, Oklahoma.
Hey, oh, Tulsa.
Tulsa. Matter of fact, they just had the anniversary of the Black Wall Street.
All right. Yeah.
1921 massacre. It was May 31st, June
1st.
Yeah. Man.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yes, got our own time.
So, yeah. Yes. So I just wanted to kind of call in and touch on that and give my opinion and my perspective, you know, on that.
That's some good stuff. That's good stuff.
Beautiful.
Thank you.
Good hearing from you, Oklahoma.
Thank you. Talk to y'all later. Have
all
a good
right. Thank you for calling
Thank
in.
Thank you. Man.
Awesome.
Yeah, we got a good call. She said y'all need to get some y'all own
damn inspiration.
Self-motivation.
That's right. Self-motivation, inspiration. Empowering self.
Exactly.
And don't be pushed by your friends or do nothing silly that you don't feel like you think. Or nobody.
Be your own person.
Yeah, or nobody. You know?
Man.
That was an important call.
Very important for these young ladies out here that don't, you know, find themselves or need to find themselves.
You know what? And what I like about it is that, you know, young listeners, young female listeners, they need to hear that. They need to hear that, you know, be comfortable with yourself.
Of course.
Don't fall into peer pressure.
Do you, boo.
Do you.
Of course.
What's his name?
Oh, God.
That's, what's his name?
Cardi B?
Was it Cardi? I was thinking, the one that do the trap music. One that always be making noises.
Panda.
Designer.
Who is that?
I've been saying that before.
Sorry,
and Designer.
Oh, that's something you like? Do it again? Okay. Oh, you saying like okay with a older bird?
Yeah. Yes.
Like a pigeon.
You got to roll the tongue.
Like an okay.
You got it. That's it. Put it up. Whoa. No, wait a minute now. You lost. We had a caller call in one time and call all of us moist. Me and Doree said, you guys are moist.
He's a dumb. Don't even call me.
Yeah.
Don't call me.
Don't even say that word. Oh,
I know.
You can't make that right. You just can't make it right.
But I guess we can shut down unless y'all got some hope because the sun's still up. What's the sun still doing up?
Man, it's summertime.
It's almost 9 o'clock.
Summertime. That time of the year.
Summer.
Stay cool.
What's up, Jeremiah?
It's working.
Oh.
I was just talking about your sister, Tequila. That's my cousin. Sister. That was a little baby doll. She was a baby.
Okay.
And,
did y'all hear about Serena Williams, though?
What?
She withdrew. She withdrew from the,
withdrew?
From the,
From the
match?
Withdrew from the French Open before playing Maria Sharapova.
Well, I heard she had won a match, her first match I played in the baby. Why did she, she just didn't want to play? They had history, though. They got real.
Why she?
I wouldn't say it's history when you've been consecutively beaten 14 times.
By the same girl?
But well, no. What I mean is when I say they got history, it's like off the, you know, when you verbalize and she says, you know, something about it.
I don't fool with Serena no more.
Why?
Because I don't want to.
No, tell me what it really is. What it is. She left. She's gone now. She got Chicago billionaire.
She left with Congress.
She caught a billionaire. That's the thing now.
Yeah.
She caught a billionaire.
Wow. A non-violent.
Well, as far as we know yet.
As far as we know.
No police cars. Let's call Janet.
Oh. Let's ask Janet.
They've been calling this woman all types of names in the books all her life. You don't really expect her to get a black man. I'm just saying, that's what I'm saying. Y'all motivate yourself. Forget what other people say about you. That's true. Be comfortable in your own skin. And that's a very, very valid point to that. But at the same time, motivate yourself. She was unfortunate, though, with the Drake of all people. That's the black man that she chose to get to. So, of course, she's going to steer away from all black men after getting with Drake. It's Drake.
Why would you say that?
It's Drake.
She was with Common.
Yeah, she was with Common.
Why she go for the white man? Ah, that's why she went with a thug white dude.
What?
Light skin, white dude. I mean, that's basically
kind of
the same thing.
She basically, I got a light skin friend like Michael Jackson. Got a dark skin friend look like Michael Jackson.
she didn't get a dark skin.
She never met with a dark skin dude. When her daddy walked in, this bad, this bad. My daddy was a dark guy too. She looked just like him. Both of them. Oh my god, that cat suit was nice though. I mean, I like the material on that. She did give a lot of dudes chance. Somebody said that her plate wasn't clean.
What?
Her plate was dirty.
Do y'all know what she does for fun?
So? What?
She buys houses for fun.
What's that got to do with dirty plates?
Property. She buys properties for fun.
That's not fun. That's business.
That's what she calls her leisure.
Anyway, they said that her plate was dirty. Her backyard.
Who's these people that said that?
Who is that?
they wouldn't come over no more.
Yeah. I think Drake. I don't have to talk.
Drake. They wouldn't. They
That's
wouldn't allow
blackface. They was all on a plate.
Look, they wouldn't be over. They wouldn't be over no more.
That wasn't blackface. That was black butt.
No.
Did I taking an ugly turn.
I look blackface all my life.
Wait a minute.
Oh. So Serena, wash your stank ass.
What?
Oh, after the tennis matches, talking about you want to lay up, you want to spoon somebody. Not with that gumbo spoon.
Wait, hold on.
Sorry.
I want to know who they is.
You said. Wait a minute. You said, hold on. That's why it was blackface.
That wasn't blackface. That was.
That was Serena's place.
No. Okay. I'm in no way, shape, or form.
Hey, write it down. Okay.
Don't come.
Yes, billions.
Don't come get
it. She is billions.
I ain't slandering you, boo.
She is billions.
I'm with you, boo.
I don't care. I'll play in tennis for it.
Whatever. You wouldn't win.
You would not.
I'll practice. Give me a couple weeks of practice.
That wouldn't be enough.
Nah.
That wouldn't be enough.
Give me a couple weeks.
Yeah.
And some good shoes and some socks.
You still lose.
And a back rub and I'll take
and
out.
You would lose.
Y'all don't believe in you, boy. I'm self-motivated.
You can be self-motivated all you want.
You could probably beat Maria Shaprova.
Yeah, you could probably beat her. You ain't beat Serena.
I'll beat Serena.
I don't know many people on the planet that could beat Serena. It's just not gonna happen.
I mean, if you go 14 years of winning every single year, back-to-back, against the same person.
He said she did find somebody.
She found somebody that was fine with her play. Yeah, because he liked to be in blackface.
Oh, no, this is taking a part of the Serena.
Nasty turn. I'm joking, Serena.
Nasty turn.
I like the cat too, though.
Of course you do.
How you got in there?
Wow.
It's like a back, it's the opening in the back and she just jump in it.
Listen!
How you get in there? I'm serious, this is real serious.
Ass plate. Huh? Yeah, ass plate. That's what he's trying to do.
Jesus. This is what happened. Second black show goes. You just never
know what you gonna get.
Well, I just want to know how you get in them cat suits. Do you jump in through the neck or does it have a zipper? Especially hers, it was all spandex, right? Like, what? How you get in there?
A cat suit.
She just
dipped it from the back
end. You know, like a onesie. Oh, like a big onesie.
Yeah, you know.
Okay.
Like
a hoodie. But I didn't see no zipper on it, though. It was like a superhero suit. There you go.
Probably
concealed.
There you go.
Ain't no Velcro strapped on that.
I can't even say it was Velcro.
It was Velcro.
No Velcro.
It was at the neck.
At the neck only.
Because
it didn't work.
No,
it would pop open.
Mm.
Oh.
It was a nice suit. I like that fabric on it.
Oh,
I like that fabric.
Yeah, I think
zipper was probably on the side.
Yeah, probably so.
Under arm.
Mm-hmm. I don't know how she wasn't hot in that. I was hot. That's ridiculous.
Mm. I got hot looking at it.
Oh, Lord.
Dun, 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 dun. But that's it, y'all. We gonna go.
Thank y'all for coming out.
Thank y'all for watching. I'm Suki Black, and we have
Yana Sakara.
Zeke over here.
And Zeke over here. You want to give out your social media handles?
You guys can follow me. Yana Sakara, YANNASEKKARA. That is, YANNASEKKARAJ. That is my Instagram, my Facebook, it's just Ayana James. Oh, yeah. I know it's long, but hey, it's my full name. What's poppin', y'all?
Oh, graduation. I thought we No. I want to give a shout out to Instagram, Snapchat, especially Snapchat for
no, that's all my Snapchat. That's all right. Get it out there. Get it out there.
My business page, Yonah the MUA. I am a makeup artist and esthetician. So, I mean, hey, if y'all got a wedding coming up, you know, graduation is already here, something, hit your girl up.
Yeah. You can put that down. Gotcha. Oh, write that down. Write that down.
Yonah the MUA.
There you go. Yana. This is my little niece, y'all. Thank you. Come here. Come here. So man, right here. This is Lily's mom. This is Aaliyah's mommy.
Oh.
She's so sweet. And me. I'm Silky Black. On everything, pretty much. Snapchat. I really don't fool with Snapchat that much. Instagram, I'm trying to get more into Instagram. And of course, Facebook, Cookie Black. And that's it, y'all.
That's it.
Hey, we are.
Peace.
Hey.